I'm Channing McCorriston, the Container Guy. In this video, we are going to put Container Modification World's BigAir 45 vents to the test. We have a wire pull smoke here, blue color, that's we're gonna set off inside this 40-foot high cube one-time use shipping container. This has two BigAir 45s installed up high in opposing corners. That's two less than we recommend in 40s. We'd like to see two high and two low. But nevertheless, we're gonna set this thing off and show you how well this ventilation setup exhausts air out of this container and how long it takes to exchange the air and for everything to circulate. So without further ado, let's try this out. There it goes. There you have it. I don't know what's happening beside me yet, but it's, that can will be filling up with smoke right now, and then we'll see how these passively ventilate the air out of this thing. So here we go. I think blue might have been a bad color given the sky's nice and blue right now to really get a visual on how much this is exhausting. Seem to maybe stop there a bit, but there's no fans in here. There's nothing blowing this air out. This is the natural pressure of the earth creating, you know, all that smoke or exhausting everything. So when you have two vents inside your container, one's an intake, one's exhaust, and it really depends on the wind direction, the sun, who knows? There's so many variables that would change that, but you can see here, air is moving out of this thing. A lot of times you can stick your hand up by these things and feel like a good airflow. And so now this just really helps us visualize this. Pretty happy with how, you know, this is exhausting, especially inside of a 40-foot, which is, you know, two vents what we suggest for a 20 and four for a 40. So we'd, you know, potentially see double this air movement if we had the proper amount of vents. And these here, these are the BigAir 45 vents. They're sold on Amazon, or you can check out our website, tcg.ca. We have all of our modification products and accessories available there. We have other types of vents, and something that's really cool coming out shortly here is we have a solar-powered axial fan and a small solar panel that's connected to these things. So all throughout the day, as the sun's beating on your container, it'll actually be running an axial fan and exhausting the air out. So really pulling it out, and then you pair that with two of these vents, and then the other two would passively ventilate all throughout the night. And so here, I guess what's interesting to note, this wall right here is facing due south. So this is the south wall, the sun's beating on it right now, and the wind's coming from the west and blowing east. So if someone's planning on, or they wanna really know which side to put a vent, or especially if you wanted to control which one would be an intake or exhaust, or just know which one, in this variable, in this instance, with a wind from the west, the sun beating on it on a south wall, we are having this vent be the exhaust, and the north vent that does not have any sun on it is the intake. So it's been almost an hour, or right about an hour, and so we want to jump inside this thing and see how well it's removed all that smoke. It produces a ton of blue powdery smoke inside there, so we'll see how much is left. Smells like gunpowder in here, so yeah, there's still some time to go. Like, I wouldn't call it a full air exchange where every speck of air inside this container has fully exhausted out and exchanged, but I wonder in a non-vented can, if we set one of these off and came back into it in an hour, it would just be like a blue cloud entirely just overtaking you as you open the door. So I'm certain this has made a huge difference. And again, this is only half the amount of vents that we recommend for 40s. We'd like to see a couple low as well, and then you get some nice cross flow ventilation with whether it's just the hot air and cold air, or if there's any vapors in here, you can exhaust fumes that would be either heavier or lighter than air through having high and low ventilation. So that's definitely a recommendation if someone's looking to install these big air 45 vents. But I guess, hope you enjoyed our little experiment here. It was fun doing it. If you enjoyed the video, please help us out and give it a like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe to our channel and ring that bell for notification. And as always, check us out at tcg.ca. Hope you learned something.